What's going on, everybody? Dr. Nathan Thompson here with Exemplify Health Center, your Wellness Way affiliate right here in Yorkville, Illinois. Hope you guys are having a great Monday. Hope you guys had a great New Year's. Hope you guys are having a great start to 2022. Boy, this time goes by really fast. All right, guys, I am back. I took about a two-week hiatus of doing some live videos and things like that, and got refreshed, got re-energized, and am feeling good and ready to bring you guys some awesome information and some awesome content as we start this new year. And if you guys are joining me right now, please let me know where you're watching from. I always love to see where people are watching from. I know that we have a lot of people from all over the world, Australia, New Zealand, from Europe, a lot of people from Canada. How you doing, Canada? And also from the United States. So let me know where you guys are watching from. I always love, I promise you this, I always read every comment. I can't respond, obviously, to all of them, but I read every single comment, good and bad. There's some interesting ones, to say the least. All right, guys, I want to answer for you guys a question. And a lot of times if I do a live video, I've gotten this question a lot, you know, during consultations or people reaching out and asking this question. And so this right here, I have gotten a lot, okay? So I've gotten a lot of this question, post-COVID hair loss. So I have had some patients who have had COVID, and then they asked me this question. They're like, I'm losing my hair left and right. And so it's like literally just coming out in clumps. And usually this happens, you know, anywhere from about 6 to 8 weeks after they have in fact had COVID. So I want to answer this question for you. In fact, what I'm going to talk about is I'm going to talk about hair loss in general, and how to kind of decipher between the different types of hair loss and really try to figure out, okay, why is this happening? Is this my thyroid? Is this because of something that's hormonal like DHT, for example? Or is it possible that this is, you know, some kind of hair loss post-trauma, whether it's chemical, physical, or whether it's mental? So hopefully, guys, when you guys watch this video, you'll be able to kind of determine, oh, this is the reason why. But at the end, I'm going to give you guys some tips on what you can do, especially if you have been suffering literally hair falling out, especially if you have had COVID in the past. Okay. Before I do that, guys, while people are joining us, if you are from the Yorkville area, and I mean Yorkville area within about a 15 to 20 mile radius, and we do in fact have mostly women that are watching this, so grab your men, ladies, because coming up, this is going to be on Saturday, kicking off January 29th, we are doing, I'm leading this, a special event just for men, okay? So, the joke is, you know, most of my patients are in fact women, and women typically are going to come in first. And the reason why is because women will feel a lot more lousy, with want of a better word, when they start seeing some hormone fluctuations, okay? Hormones will make you feel lousy, but they're not the reason why you're sick. And so women a lot of times will actually feel sick for a lot longer than a man. Like a man, you know, other than maybe not having very good energy, you know, they typically just go their whole lives and then just kind of drop dead. And so, but they're both sick, okay? So on this event, this is gonna be for men only, we're gonna talk about specifically the number one thing that the ladies tell me about their men, especially during consults, and that has to do with men and testosterone. So on that event, we're going to talk about how to increase your testosterone for men without all of the gimmicks that are actually out there, okay? There's so many gimmicks that are out there, and in fact, we're going to talk about how you increase testosterone without supplementing at all. And so we're going to go over tips, ideas, strategies, and how a man should eat, how a man should exercise, and then we're going to take it a step further because we're going to do a four-week challenge after that, and this is life-changing for men. A lot of times when women's like, what on earth did you do to my husband? He has completely changed and transformed. He's actually has turned into the man that I married. So guys, if your man is suffering from low testosterone, you're going to see a decrease in sex drive. You're going to see a decrease in energy. You're going to see a decrease in libido. You're going to see a decrease in just motivation. You're just going to see a decrease in so many other things. And so hormonally, there are so men who are just so sick. And we're going to talk about the biggest roadblocks, you know, that are happening in men as far as testosterone production and how they can start literally increasing their testosterone with all these other like gimmicks and supplements and exogenous hormones and things like that. So when I'm done here, I'll leave the link in the title of this video so that if you are from the area, you can register or give the link to your man. He can register for it. And we're going to be doing also on that day, we'll talk to you about the 4-week challenge that we're going to be doing afterwards. So we got some awesome things planned as far as how to eat, how to fast, how to exercise, and then also how to defend yourself, defend your family with situational awareness and also ammunition. So it's going to be a really awesome event. Men absolutely love it. We've seen so many men transform. The beginning of the transformation really starts at this event. All right. All right, let's talk about hair loss, guys, because so many people have asked me this question. Dr. Nate, I got COVID, and then, you know, 6 to 8 weeks later, all of a sudden, my hair just started falling out. What is going on? Will this ever end? Will it reverse? You know, what's going on? I also get the question quite a bit, too, when it comes to hair loss in general. Yes, this can be men, but this can also be women. So there's really just three main areas that if you are having some loss of hair or maybe loss of hair thickness, or if you're having thinning hair, or maybe your hair is just falling out, these are the three main areas, guys, where you need to look at. So a lot of times, you know, if a woman, her hair is falling out, the first thing that they're going to run to is they're going to blame their thyroid, okay? And hair really won't fall out when it's due to a thyroid issue, as much as it is going to be that their hair is growing more slowly and the actual health of the hair and the follicle starts to suffer. So typically with the thyroid issue, one of the things that you're going to see is you're going to see that the hair is very slow growing. You're also going to see that the actual hair becomes very thin and can become very brittle, okay? So not all reasons why hair is falling out is due to the thyroid. So typically that describes someone who is having like a hypothyroid type of symptom. Now, it's very important, guys, that if someone does in fact have a thyroid issue, that you make sure that you're getting it tested properly. When we're testing a thyroid, we're testing 18 different markers. Yes, there is things like TSH, yes, there's T3, yes, there's T4, but there's free T3, free T4, there is reverse T3, there is, you know, checking for thyroid antibodies, TPO antibodies, thyroglobulin antibodies, checking cortisol levels, actually looking at other markers just with the CBC, white blood cells, looking for inflammatory markers as well. So we look at the thyroid from a huge, like very comprehensively. Because remember, guys, if you're having an issue with your thyroid, it's not your thyroid. Your thyroid is actually responding and it's not actually causing you to become sick. So by the time your thyroid starts to get bad, you are so far down so many steps of problems with the gastrointestinal system, with the liver, with the immune system, the thyroid is really just the last thing to actually go that will then cause you to become symptomatic. So the second thing I want to go over with you too is the second reason for hair loss can be due to what's known as high DHT or dihydrotestosterone. So dihydrotestosterone is really a derivative of the hormone testosterone, but it's about 10 times more potent than testosterone. Yes, ladies can have high DHT, and yes, men can have high DHT as well. And in fact, the one more reason for men losing their hair and having male pattern baldness is the fact of high DHT or dihydrotestosterone. So here's what's interesting, is you'll notice that there's medications out there to try to prevent this type of hair loss. And basically all they are, guys, is they are just known as DHT blockers. So they actually block the production of dihydrotestosterone. But what's interesting is that rather than that testosterone going into DHT, they take that testosterone and they divert it into estradiol, which is why a common side effect of people that are taking DHT blockers, men and women, is they start to have increased estradiol levels, which means that for a man, it can really hurt you, like sex drive. You can start gaining weight around the hips and the butt. You can start to grow breasts. And so you got to be really, really careful. we always want to get to the reason why someone has high DHT, and especially if men, if you have high DHT, you're also going to notice that your prostate is going to swell. So what's interesting is that doctors give the same medications to prevent balding than they do in order to prevent the prostate from swelling, because it's the same hormone that's acting on the hair follicle that's also acting on the actual prostate gland. Now, women can also have high DHT, and I've also seen some situations where women have very high DHT, and if they do, they're also going to have some issues with their menstrual cycle. But if a woman does, in fact, have high DHT, one of the things that you'll notice is that you'll actually be usually having frontal balding in through here. So you'll actually see that the whole entire hair begins thinning, and you'll actually see it from the scalp, and it'll start to go back at that point. Now, if a woman still has high DHT as they go into menopause, you'll see this accelerate even faster after menopause, and you'll see that they'll start to catch up even with men when it comes to male pattern baldness. But the one that most people have been asking me about is this whole idea behind infection, stress, and trauma. And one of those infections or the stressor or the trauma can be due to having a COVID infection. Really, it's not something that's like it's COVID that's causing the hair loss as much as you having a really nasty infection. So having a nasty infection, and this could be COVID, this could be the flu, this could be, you know, having the measles, this could be having chickenpox, or undergoing a tremendous amount of stress that requires a lot of nutrients to get pulled through your adrenal glands. And the same thing could actually happen too after you've had a major physical trauma. For example, like having a you know, major burn, or having a major car accident, where that stressor can actually cause you to start to lose your hair. But if you're talking about COVID, you're talking about having an infection and about having a really big stress on the immune system, okay? Now, this is not something that, you know, that people have just turned a blind eye towards. In fact, I went to the whole trusted PubMed.gov. Where'd we find this? PubMed. And there is actually an article, and this comes from November of this year. So this is something that they have been studying pretty recently from the Dermatological Therapeutics Journal. So November of 2021. So it literally just came out not even 2 months ago. And it was called COVID-19-induced telogen effluvium. Basically, that's a big scientific word to scare you, saying post-COVID-induced hair loss, meaning the hair has undergone a trauma and it has starting to fallen out or starting to shed. So here's a big long article about all the different things that they talked about, but this is what they actually said, because this is pretty common when you're looking at the number of people who have had a true COVID infection, not necessarily a positive PCR test, because we know that a PCR test doesn't tell you that you have any kind of infection. It is just actually picking up the DNA either from the flu or from COVID-19 or from even another coronavirus like the common cold. This is a true infection that you are having. So here's what they found, was that hair loss was seen in over 25% of the cases. So about a quarter of the cases, people saw noticeable hair loss after COVID-19 infection. It actually, the hair loss didn't start until 54 days on average after a positive test. So it didn't happen all at once. And in fact, it took about a month and a half to 2 months after receiving a positive test before the hair started to come out. What's interesting though is that it was 7 times higher in women than in men, but what's also interesting is that it was twice as high in people with high blood pressure, okay? Now, I know you're probably saying, oh, high blood pressure is a symptom of you going to lose your hair. No, it's not. It is seen in people who have high blood pressure. It's also seen twice as much in people who are having the respiratory symptoms of COVID-19. But the thing is I want you to think about it, is that when people do have high blood pressure or people have higher respiratory symptoms due to COVID-19, it just means that they're less healthy. It doesn't mean that that is what's causing the hair loss. It means that the immune system needed a whole lot more work and support, and it needed to work extra hard in order for you to be able to overcome this infection. And then finally, what they found was the worse the symptoms, the more common the hair loss, okay? So it wasn't that COVID attacked you more, it was you had a lot more overt symptoms. And the reason why you had the whole more overt symptoms, which I highlighted here, was because your immune system really wasn't up to par. This guy goes back to the whole idea that two people can get the same infection, and one ends up, you know, in the hospital, and the other person feels like they had the common cold for 1 or 2 days, and then they're fine. It's the same virus, but the difference is not the virus. The difference is the strength of the host. So one of the things that I take away from this is the worse your immune system is, the more likely you are to, in fact, start to have hair loss. So think of this: COVID-19 is an infection that it's affecting the elderly more. Why? Because they have a lot more damage, unresolved damage. It's affecting immune system function. But when you look at kids, the only kids who have been affected, like by death, are the ones who were already immunocompromised to begin with. So they may have been undergoing chemotherapy, which destroys the immune system. They might have had autoimmunity, and the doctors were giving them a drug-induced poor immune function. And so, but a normal child, healthy child, if you took a child that doesn't have asthma, doesn't have allergies, isn't on any kind of medications, and they have COVID-19, guys, they're sick for 1 or 2 or 3 days. I don't know why we are trying to shut down the schools and mask the children when this is a very common, easily handled infection that their immune systems are stronger as a result of actually having the infection. It gets stronger. It's a muscle, and your immune system has to be strengthened. Your immune system has to be trained. And how do you train your immune system? Through constant, never-ending exposure. I'm sorry, but that's just how it is. That's how it is based on physiology. So who are the ones who are going to be losing their hair? It's the ones who have the poorest immune system function, okay? So here's, guys, what you can do. Here's what you can do. Excuse me, not COVID. If you have experienced hair loss, understand this, is that it probably isn't going to be happening until about 6 to 8 weeks after initial infection, which could mean that it may not happen for a month after the symptoms go away. It may not happen maybe two weeks. We have some people who are COVID long haulers who just can't get over it because their immune systems are so weak. They may develop a secondary infection like Epstein-Barr virus, just because that having that COVID infection will lower the immune response, you know, initially to have a reactivation of other viruses. So it may be 2 weeks, maybe 4 weeks, maybe 6 weeks before you start to have noticeable hair loss. And what you're going to notice is you're going to notice more the hair falling out, not necessarily thinning, not necessarily having frontal baldness, but you're going to experience the hair just starting to come out in clumps. Excuse me. And in fact, some people who are so inflamed, who are so sick, their hair can fall out because of that, and it has nothing to do with COVID. So what can you do if this is happening? The first thing that I will tell you is this, is relax, all right? You're not gonna lose all of your hair. It's going to slow down, but basically what your body is doing is your body said, I need to divert all of these nutrients, you know, required to feed the hair follicle, and I need to divert them to something more important, which is handling an immune response. This is also why people lose their sense of taste and smell. The body diverts zinc to go to the immune system and says, we don't need the zinc that's associated with the ability to be able to taste and the ability to be able to smell. I tell people, if you did lose your taste and smell, start supplementing with zinc as quickly as possible, because the longer you stay zinc deficient, the harder it is to regrow that specific skin and those receptors in order to be able to taste and smell. There's some people 6 months later, they still haven't gotten it back. So the first thing that I want you to do is if this is happening, start feeding the hair follicle, okay? So start feeding the hair follicle. So how do you feed the actual hair follicle? Is do some really, really awesome things that are gonna give it the nutrients that it needs. First one that I love is actually either eat liver or take a desiccated liver, which is basically liver dried, ground up, and then put into capsule form, which I actually will recommend for my patients that we're seeing probably 70 to 80% of the time I get them on a desiccated liver. Now the reason why is some of the most bioavailable sources of B vitamins, things like B3, B5, B6, B9, B12, are all present in desiccated liver. So a lot of times what we think is, oh my gosh, my hair doesn't look very good. I need to feed it from the outside, meaning I need to put it on my hair, but that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. The follicle is on the inside. So you need to feed the follicle from the inside. Liver also contains things that the follicle needs like vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E. And so you can't find anything better than something that, a desiccated liver can actually provide for you, okay? Number two, start feeding it astragalus, guys. I absolutely love astragalus, and if you've heard me speak before, I've even talked about astragalus and the ability of astragalus to prevent cell death in the intervertebral disc. When people are getting things like disc herniations, we'll put them on astragalus because it helps that disc cells not to die. When they die, they thin, they crack, they bulge, they herniate. And so astragalus helps even with that. Astragalus will feed the bone marrow in order to increase stem cells. But just remember is that at the level of the follicle are stem cells that then turn into actual the hair shaft. So astragalus will be able to provide the stem cells at the location of the hair follicle. So guys, take vitamin D. Vitamin D is involved in over 1,500 genetic functions within the body. And yes, you can go ahead and look up vitamin D levels and also hair loss and alopecia and balding. Vitamin D is absolutely incredible when it comes to growing hair and keeping preserving hair. You also need vitamin C. And then yes, you also need some zinc. All of those are going to help with if you shed the hair to be able to start growing new hair, okay? Also, what's cool about liver is that there is some zinc that is gonna be in liver as well. Now, if you did lose your hair post-COVID, the more important thing that I would tell you to do is test your immune system. So again, this didn't happen in everyone who had COVID, but it happened in 28% of the people. And the 28% of the people are the ones who had the most severe symptoms. And the ones who had the most severe symptoms are the ones with the weakest immune system that had a hard time overcoming a viral infection. So if you did lose your hair, that's your body saying, hey, my immune system actually needs to be stronger. I had to divert so much away, even from my hair, maybe from my tongue and from my nasal epithelium and nasal skin. And so I had to use that to give it to the immune system. If I had enough of it, I could keep my taste and smell. So test your immune system, guys. And there are not very many doctors that are testing the immune system properly. Within the wellness way, we are. And so basically, you should be looking at a CBC, complete blood count. You should be looking at, you know, which is basic blood work, but then you expand it, write this down, CD4, CD8, CD19, and natural killer cells. Because chances are, what you would be lacking in would be in actual lymphocytes, and specifically T cells. So CD8 and CD4 cells, you're probably very deficient in, which then makes it very hard for you to be able to overcome a viral infection. See, this is the whole idea with a viral infection, is one of the things that we want to focus on is not having a weak immune system in the first place. But what we also want to do is, someone is in fact sick, we want to actually prevent the virus from replicating, which is what licorice root does a great job of doing. But we also want to feed those CD4 and those CD8 cells, which means that you're getting more vitamin D, you're taking things like wormwood, medicinal mushrooms, astragalus can do that. And so that you're feeding those things in order to provide more blood, white blood cells or T cells, so that they can begin catching up and taking care of these virally infected cells. So test your immune system, guys. I can't stress that enough. You need to be doing that at least one time a year, and probably the best time to be doing it is not when you're already sick, but testing in September so that you can start working on it during the cold and flu season, guys. The reason why we're so sick right now isn't because it's necessarily December or January. It's because we just got done with 6 weeks of probably neglecting our health, being really stressed out, not sleeping enough, and then not being out in the sun and not getting enough vitamin D. The last thing that I will tell you is this, is that yes, your hair will grow back unless there's some kind of autoimmune condition that has destroyed the hair follicle, but how long is it gonna take? It's going to take about 6 to 9 months. So eventually it will stop, and then the hair actually has to grow up through the skin, which means it can grow for a whole entire month before you'll see it actually come through the skin. So before it can get back to normal, it's going to take about 6 to 9 months. So eventually it will happen. So make sure that you feed the follicle, get your immune system tested, and then just be patient, because you can't make hair grow any faster than what it's actually supposed to do. The biggest thing that I want to tell you guys is this, is that if you had post-COVID hair loss, I want to tell you that you were deficient, okay? You were deficient. Your immune system was deficient, and your body needed the nutrients to survive. So it pulled the nutrients that it needed, things like B vitamins, A, D, E, you know, K, whatever nutrients it was, and it will pull it the resources from wherever it can get it to do one thing, to help you survive, because hair is not needed for survival. I want you guys to understand that, is your body will prioritize everything to do to first and foremost help you survive. And you overcoming an infection is the body's number one survival response. So it does not care about your hair. It doesn't care about anything else. It needs all nutrients in order to be able to survive, and it will pull it from wherever it needs to, which is why, guys, which is why, you know, if you are really, really stressed out, chronically having a lot of mental stress, your body will start to steal things like vitamin C and things like that. And it doesn't care about the vitamin C that you need in order to make healthy collagen, which is why people, when they're so mentally stressed long-term, which is why their skin starts to age so quickly. So that's why when you're under stress, why you need more of those nutrients more than ever before, like collagen and vitamin C. But the same thing is that you were deficient and the immune system needed it, and it said, I need you to live. Let's take it from wherever we can. And a side effect was you actually having your hair start to fall out. Guys, does that make sense? I hope it does. And if it does, please share this. I guarantee you, you know, you probably had, I don't know, 90 million, 100 million people who have suffered with COVID, and potentially you could be looking at, I don't know, 20, 25 million people who are suffering hair loss and they don't know what to turn. In fact, what they're probably doing right now is they're probably on Amazon trying to find the most expensive shampoo with biotin to try to rub into their scalp, when in reality, it's not an outside-in issue, it's an inside-out issue. You need to feed it from the inside out and not just rub things, obviously, on your hair. So guys, one last thing. Coming up, if you are from the Yorkville area within a 15 to 20 minute radius, please, please, please get your man registered for our Man Up event and challenge coming up Saturday, January 29th. I'll leave the link in the title of this video. Register for it. It's at 10:30. There is no charge to actually come to the event. I'm going to be talking about the biggest roadblocks to testosterone production, but it's not enough to teach. We actually show and we implement. And so for those who are going to be interested in our 4-week Man Up Challenge after that, guys, this is an awesome, awesome event. This is one of the rare events where I actually take people personally through it. But we involve things like exercise. We involve things like nutrition. We involve things, the biggest roadblocks. We show that and we do it, most importantly. And men can notice an unbelievable change just in 4 weeks of doing that. So we'll go over more details about what it entails at that event, but it's also a lot of one-on-one time with me. It's a lot of time that's spent with other awesome people, and it's just a great event that you will actually be able to experience it, be able to learn it, and also at the end, we have an awesome dinner together with our wives. It's an awesome experience. It's my favorite one because I don't like to just teach people. I like to show people what the way is, and this is our great way to start to get your man especially on track. So come back to this video, you know, if you're watching it right now, and I'll leave the link up there. Get your man registered for that. I promise you, he will not regret changing his life, just like I did, you know, 11 years ago. Changed my life. My wife thanked me profusely for doing that. All right, guys, if you have any more topics you'd like me to discuss coming up in 2022, just leave that in the comments below as well. And we are always looking for topics and ideas as far as our live videos, but we'll be seeing you either on Monday evenings or on Saturday mornings, just depending on what my schedule will allow. And hopefully for 2022, we can give you awesome content that you can learn, that you can grow, and then become the healthiest version of you. So guys, be well. Have a great rest of your Monday night, and we will see you guys very soon.